Good morning, class. We have a great week for you in terms of quadratic equations. By the end of today's lesson, students will be able to define the equation for the axis of symmetry of a quadratic to be x equals negative b over 2a, and use this to find the vertex of a quadratic equation. You'll be also able to graph any quadratic in standard form, and you'll be able to determine that a quadratic could have a 0, 1, or 2 real solutions. Some essential questions that we have for today are, is this quadratic trinomial factorable or is it not? How do we utilize the axis of symmetry in order to calculate the vertex point and to complete the graph of a parabola? All today in Escobar's class. Morning class, welcome to 4.29 graphing quadratics in standard form. The key question that we have today is, what other tools do we have to graph a parabola aside from factoring or completing the square? Okay, so today, as we already know, the standard form is when y equals ax squared plus bx plus c. And the question we always must ask ourselves is, is this quadratic trinomial factorable? Okay, if yes, plot the roots like we have here, and then find or calculate the halfway point to identify the axis of symmetry and the vertex point. Okay, because again, the axis of symmetry is halfway between both of the roots, and it will lead to our vertex point when you substitute the axis of symmetry value into that equation. This is all review. However, if it's not factorable, we can complete the square to rewrite in vertex form y equals a times the quantity of x minus h squared plus k. Or we can calculate the axis of symmetry, and that is what we're going to be learning about today. The axis of symmetry equation is when x equals negative b over 2a. This is going to be this line, right? It's also going to be the x coordinate of the vertex point. And that is what we're going to be learning today. Let's go into example one. Graph the function y equals x squared minus 6x plus 7. The first thing we have to ask ourselves is this factorable? Okay, are there two products of 7 that when added together gets us negative 6? Well, we know that 7 times 1 is a product of 7, and negative 7 times negative 1. However, when we add these values together, 7 plus 1 is positive 8, and negative 7 plus negative 1 is negative 8. So neither of these equal to negative 6, which is that b value we needed to equal to. Now, the second question is, what type of concavity and extrema we have? Well, as far as concavity goes, right, we have to look at our a value. A equals a positive 1, therefore it is concave upwards. Anytime A is greater than 1, it's concave upwards. Also, anytime that A is greater than 1, our extrema is going to be a minimum. So that is our extrema and our concavity. Once we have identified those two features, we're going to identify A, B, and C of the equation y equals x squared minus 6x plus 7. Okay? We already know that A equals 1, positive 1. B equals negative 6. And C equals positive 7. Make sure you have all this in your notes. So now, step 4, calculate the axis of symmetry. We do this by substituting the values in for the variables. So we have now x equals negative 6. Again, because b equals negative 6, we just make that direct substitution. So always remember you're having that negative 6 in there. And we divide that by 2 times the value of A, which is positive 1. And now we just solve. X equals a negative times a negative is a positive 6. And 2 times positive 1 is 2. And when we make our final simplified response, 6 over 2 is 3. This is our axis of symmetry. Now when we graph the axis of symmetry, we go to 1, 2, 3, when x equals 3, and draw that dotted line. When x equals 3, x. We're going to substitute the axis of symmetry to complete the vertex point xy. So now we have y equals, instead of x squared, it is 3 squared minus 6 times 3 plus 7. And now we just solve. 3 squared is 9, negative 6 times 3 is negative 18. Added by 7, 9 minus 18 is negative 9, plus 7, y equals negative 2, therefore our point is going to be 3, comma, negative 2, which on the graph is going to be right here. And it is a minimum, right? The lowest point. Step 6. Find two other coordinate points of the parabola. So we need to, because we know this is going concave upwards, we have to think of which x values would be good points so we can substitute and solve. I'm going to just use when x equals 1, okay, because it's close to the axis of symmetry and not too far. So when I substitute, I then get y1 squared minus 6 times 1 plus 7. And when I solve, it's 1 minus 6 plus 7, which then 1 minus 6 is negative 5. So I get negative 5 plus 7, which results in y equals 2, resulting in the point 1, 2. Okay? So now, when I graph my vertex point, when I graph 1, 2 here, okay, we're going to go through step 7 and reflect over the axis of symmetry. So if I know there are 2.2 units away from the axis of symmetry on the left side, then I know there will be a reflective point 2 units away to the right side of the axis of symmetry. So when I graph my parabola, it should be a reflection on both left and right side, as you see here. The question that I have for you all, and we'll go learn this throughout the week, is how can we determine our roots, especially when they're not at a precise whole value? Well, that's all the time that we have for today. Make sure you complete all the questions and show your work for problem set A, problem set B, and the exit ticket. Remember, the credit is in the work, not the results.
Also, thank you all for everyone to for labeling and submitting appropriately as directed from last week. Keep it up. However, due to our extended deadline, I would like for you to submit the notes appropriately and label as such. Lastly, if you were to submit your work before 4:30 p.m., you can receive 3 additional extra credit points for doing so. Other than that, please complete by 11:59 today. Well, thank you for your time. Let's all now go to office hours and have a productive day. See you next time on Escobar's Class.